everyone. Welcome back to Psychology of Rock. If you're new here, my name's Nina, and today we are finally talking about my favorite instrument and the pretty impressive cognitive impact it can have on us. Now, neuroscientists have been studying the brains of musicians for decades, if not longer, and one thing we know for sure is that playing an instrument physically changes our brain, and in a very positive way. Now, to be fair, many of these changes, like enhanced motor control, better auditory discrimination, and improved memory, can be seen in people no matter what instrument they play. But some adaptations are uniquely strong in guitarists simply because of the instrument's demands, like split-second coordination of both hands, the constant shifts between rhythm and melody, and the highly complex spatial mapping of the instrument itself. These adaptations are amazing because they not only end up making us even better guitar players in the end, but they also enhance cognitive abilities that are useful well beyond music. So let's go ahead and go through 8 specific ways our brains have been rewired through playing guitar according to science, and I will of course leave all the citations for the studies I used to make this video in the description box just in case you want to read them for yourself. And I want to specifically recommend looking at the one from 2024 called Structural and Functional Changes in the Brains of Guitarist Musicians, because I did find that one to be particularly interesting. But all in all, there was a lot more research on this topic than I was expecting to find. So for each section, I will briefly talk about the actual observable change in the brain. Then I'll explain how this change actually ends up benefiting us, not only as a musician, but also as a person. So with all of that being said, let's go ahead and dive in. Now, the first thing they noticed was bigger motor maps for the fretting hand. They observed that in the primary motor cortex, which is the brain area that directs motion, guitarists develop enlarged motor maps for whichever hand they use to make chords. We can think of these maps as very elaborate blueprints for movements. For guitarists, the map on the fretting hand becomes larger and more detailed because it's constantly handling tiny precise movements like hammer-ons, slides, and bends. This leads to faster and more accurate hand control the more we practice. But like I said earlier, the benefits don't just apply to our instrument. This fine motor wiring was also found to help in activities like typing quickly and sketching, really any delicate tasks that require precise hand-eye coordination. Now, another fascinating adaptation they found was enhanced neural communication. The study showed that playing guitar doesn't just change the size of the brain regions, it also improves how they actually communicate. It was found that musicians in general have more organized white matter in their brain's motor pathways, but for guitarists, this is especially strong in the connections between both hands. It turns out that this connectivity vastly improves the speed and efficiency of the brain's internal communication. So for guitar, this means greater speed and accuracy, but in our daily life, this could mean things like being better able to multitask or to perform complex actions that require both hands to work independently. Okay, the next change is increased cerebellar volume. The cerebellum, which is kind of tucked in the back of the brain, is responsible for managing things like timing and coordination. Studies that used MRI scans showed that it often actually grows larger in musicians, and in guitarists especially, this enlargement is tied to how demanding the instrument is. Unlike individuals who play instruments that rely more on synchronized hand movements, guitarists constantly have to coordinate two hands doing different types of things completely. This dual demand puts a huge load on the cerebellum, which eventually translates into increased resources, like faster error correction and more precise timing networks. Now, obviously, these things can help us out immensely when we're playing, but it can also help with things like balance, motor learning, and improved cognitive processing. But moving on, the next thing that was noted is stronger connections between brain hemispheres. The study showed that the corpus callosum, which links the left and right sides of our brain, is also stronger in musicians, and playing guitar specifically seems to push this even more. This is yet another positive outcome that stems from our hands performing completely different tasks, because it forces constant communication between both hemispheres of the brain. And once again, the benefits are not just musical. It actually helps us to integrate both logical and creative thinking, which is a skill that, as a guitarist, you've probably already noticed that you naturally apply to almost every aspect of your life. And I might be biased, but I do think this is a very desirable trait. Okay, next up, we have structural adaptations in the hippocampus. The study showed that the hippocampus, which is responsible for memory and spatial navigation, is another area that shows unique changes in guitarists. The constant demand of learning and memorizing songs was seen to significantly strengthen this area, making it more efficient at encoding information and retrieving complex motor sequences. This neurological boost helps us to not only actually remember the songs that we learn, but also enhances things like general memory, spatial awareness, and the ability to learn other complex physical skills more quickly. Now, another big difference they noticed had to do with enhanced auditory motor coupling, which is a core aspect of a guitarist's neuroplasticity. This is the process that strengthens the link between our brain's hearing and movement centers. Over time, this allows for a seamless connection between what we perceive and what we ultimately end up doing with that information. In other words, when we hear guitar music, our brains don't just process sound, they actually activate motor regions as if we're about to play it ourselves, which ends up helping us learn songs by ear and improvise more naturally. Outside of music, similar connections help us with things like improved speech perception and faster reaction times all around. Now, the next thing on the list is increased gray matter in music-related regions. And yes, we did already discuss white matter, but there were differences in gray matter as well. Now, this term refers to the parts of the brain where the neurons and their connections are located. When there's an increase in gray matter volume, it's a tangible sign that our brain is adapting to skills and building more efficient neural networks. The findings indicated that because of this, long-term guitar practice is linked to both greater mental agility and resilience. This contributes to a strong cognitive reserve that helps our brain adapt more effectively to new challenges throughout our entire life. And while all of this is absolutely amazing, I think maybe the most significant finding here was simply that playing guitar promotes a more integrated and unified brain overall. It turns out that guitar playing is one of the few activities that simultaneously engages almost every part of our brain at once, from our motor and auditory cortices to our emotional and memory centers. Because our brain has to constantly juggle all of these functions in real time, it's driven to build these powerful superhighways that allow different areas to communicate and collaborate much more efficiently than non-musicians. The end result is a more agile, flexible, and creative mind that can very easily process new information. In essence, every single time we play, we're physically reshaping our brains to become faster, more connected, and more adaptable, both as musicians and as human beings. I'd love to hear in the comments if these are changes that you've noticed yourself and if there's anything you'd like to add. Please do me a favor and let me know what you'd like me to cover next. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe if you have not done so already, and I will see you in the next video.